In today's video, we'll prove why the derivative of cosecant x equal to negative cosecant x times cotangent x using the limit definition of derivative, also known as the first principle. Here we have the result we need to prove. And first, let's write down the formula for the limit definition of derivative. F prime of x is the limit as h approaches 0 of f of x plus h minus f of x over h. To prove this, we'll need to utilize two results established in previous videos. The first is that as h approaches 0, the limit of sine h over h is 1. And the second is that the limit of 1 minus cosine h over h is 0. If you want to learn more about these, check out the videos in the top right corner. Now, let's denote f of x as cosecant x for our proof. Then, f of x plus h becomes cosecant x plus h. Substituting this into the green equation at the top of the screen, f prime of x becomes the limit as h approaches 0 of cosecant x plus h minus cosecant x over h. Rewriting cosecant x as 1 over sine x, f prime x becomes the limit as h approaches 0 of 1 over sine x plus h minus 1 over sine x over h. And to simplify the expression, let's multiply both the numerator and denominator by sine x plus h times sine x. This yields the expression limit of sine x minus sine x plus h over h times sine x plus h times sine x. The sine term in the numerator, sine x plus h, can be expanded using compound angle formula for trigonometric functions as sine x times cosine h plus cosine x times sine h. Substituting this result into the numerator, we get the expression limit of sine x minus sine x times cosine h plus cosine x times sine h over h times sine x plus h times sine x. Removing the parentheses in the numerator, the expression becomes limit of sine x minus sine x times cosine h minus cosine x times sine h over h times sine x plus h times sine x. Looking at the terms in the numerator, we see a common factor of sine x. And factoring out sine x, we get limit of sine x times 1 minus cosine h minus cosine x times sine h over h times sine x plus h times sine x. Now, let's express this fraction as two separate fractions. This yields limit of sine x times 1 minus cosine h over h times sine x plus h times sine x minus cosine x times sine h over h times sine x plus h times sine x. In the first fraction, we can cancel out the sine terms in the numerator and denominator. Rearranging the expression slightly, we get as h approaches 0, the limit of 1 minus cosine h over h times 1 over sine x plus h minus sine h over h times cosine x over sine x plus h times sine x. By rearranging the expression in this way, we can observe the two limit expressions mentioned earlier in the video. The limits highlighted in yellow boxes are as shown on the screen, namely 0 and 1 respectively. Using these results, let's simplify the expression. Since h approaches 0 in the limit, h in sine x plus h becomes 0, resulting in sine x. Therefore, the expression becomes 0 times 1 over sine x minus 1 times cosine x over sine x times sine x. Eventually, the first fraction disappears, leaving only the second fraction, which can be written separately as negative 1 over sine x times cosine x over sine x. So, since 1 over sine x is cosecant x, and cosine x over sine x is a reciprocal of tangent x, which is cotangent x, this result ultimately becomes negative cosecant x times cotangent x. Therefore, we have proven that the derivative of cosecant x is negative cosecant x times cotangent x. How was it? Did you understand well? The derivative of functions like sine x, cosine x, and tangent x, as well as their reciprocal functions, involves a lot of memorization, don't they? In the next video, I will explain how we can remember these formulas more easily. Please continue to show your interest and support by watching. If today's video was helpful, please like and subscribe. Thank you to all of you who watched. Until next time, I've been your math guardian, Alex.